Charlie. Mark, one Charlie.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I'm full of optimism.
Einstein's theory of relativity.
We're still seeing it quite well through that haze.
T-minus 37 seconds.
The fight is growing confident.
E equals 14, MC.
13. That all men are created equal.
About the future innovations.
And growing strength in the air.
Ignition sequence.
Tear down.
Something's happening. Coming up on staging.
This is Finding Your Frequency with your hosts, Jeff Spenard and Ryan Treasure. It's time to speak up, share your voice, and hear from the thought leaders.
And welcome to Finding Your Frequency. My name is Jeff Spenard. I am the host. I am also the CEO and president of World Talk Radio, home to the Voice America Talk Radio and TV networks. Joining me, of course, my co-host, 12-year colleague, 17-year veteran, and the Vice President of Broadcast Operations here at Voice America, Mr. Ryan Treasure. Ryan.
Hey, Jeff. Thanks for having me on today.
Of course. I'm excited
about this show. It's going to be a good one today.
You are my sidekick, man. You don't have to ever thank me for a warm welcome. You are the man. How's it going?
Good, man. Good.
This is week number four.
Yeah, week number four, and I think everything's really getting together, and we're able to piece all the book parts together and get these guests on, and it's really starting to take away.
Really starting to gel, absolutely. So let's talk about last week for a moment. Last week was all about defining your audience. We had two excellent, outstanding guests. We had Mr. Randall Libero, who shared his knowledge and his wisdom about how to start from within in your surroundings and move out. And we also had Mr. Eric Zuli, who is continuously on the move and doing different things. And I've got a little something to share about another event that's coming up soon. But Eric, who is one of the top 10 social influencers in the world, or I'm not sure if it's in the world or if it's noted somewhere, but he's one of the top 10.
Yeah, I think if it's an influencer, it's of all of the locations worldwide for Facebook and Twitter.
There we go. So anyway, okay, so we had some excellent information, so be sure if you have any questions, give us a call. Ryan, the number is?
866-472-5788.
Excellent. Okay, let's talk about something else. Before we started the show, Ryan and I had a conversation about being honest and open, because the show, Finding Your Frequency, is to teach people how to broadcast themselves and their messages. So when you get behind a mic, or you get in front of a camera, or you're doing a podcast, or you're blogging, whatever the case is, you got to kind of check yourself on what you're doing. So I want to read something that is part of our description. And then we're going to go into a couple of mistakes that we've made over the past 3 weeks. So anyway, finding your frequency is about more than just content and code. It is more than just philosophy and polishing your image. It's about both failure and success, the difference between the two, in all of the steps in between. Jeff and Ryan discussed the digital media space in all of its aspects. It's all about making the mistakes, taking the chances, summoning the intestinal fortitude to step out of your comfort zone, and discovering what you can accomplish when you decide to try, decide to learn, and decide that you have something to say and find your frequency.
Yeah, that comment, that text that you just read really synonymizes what the show is all about. Taking a piece of content and taking a chance and to deliver the message and learning along the way, yep. Which I think we've done a lot of.
We have. I got to be honest, there are certain weeks that we have fell short on preparation. While we were preparing, I think the football game was more important.
For week one.
Yeah. So, again, when you're going to prepare to get behind a mic, be sure you're ready to do it. And for the most part, I would say 90%, we are right there.
Yeah, we're real close.
Yeah.
I agree.
The other 10% is something that's going to come with time. Again, this is week number four. So, hey, we're going to get there. So anyway, that's kind of what I wanted to notice. And for me, I happen to use the word quite a bit.
Yeah, I have. I have one of mine, and I like to say, you know.
Right, right.
You know,
and is a filler. You know, the reason why I use it, and I use it all the time. That's how I talk. Period. See, there it is, and that was totally something that was not planned. So it's a filler word while you're thinking of what you want to say. It kind of fills that gap when you're trying to get that next piece of information out there.
Yeah, I think the same reason you use is the same reason why I use you know.
Right.
It's that split second where you're making sure that what you're about to say next is correct.
Right.
And so you use that filler word kind of as a crutch as you're searching around in your head for the
exactly.
next thing to say.
Exactly. So I'm going to challenge the audience. If you're paying attention, count how many us you hear and how many you knows.
You know.
You know, right. And let's see how we do this week. Okay, let's talk about this week's topic. We are looking at choosing your medium, radio, TV, or both. What do you think about that, Ryan?
I think that both mediums, radio and TV, have a distinct purpose. Mm-hmm. I think both mediums also have the ability to work in tandem to reach a given goal. So excited to talk to our guests about that exact topic today.
Absolutely.
And I know we're going to be extracting out of those guests what is their favorite medium, or do they have an opinion one way or the other?
Yeah, and I think you're going to find that both mediums with both of these people are very excited to be a part of both. But Ryan, I want to ask you first, which one's your choice?
Well, as much as I enjoy video, I love watching television, I love consuming video content, but my favorite is definitely the audio piece, and I think it's just for the simple fact that audio is the one medium that you can consume while doing other things like driving in your car.
That sounds like radio to me, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah radio. That's my I say
radio. Radio works. Yeah, you know what? I'm an old school kind of guy. You know, I go back 22 years in the business. I've always worked with radio. TV has been another one. TV has been something that the last 5 years is something we've been nurturing as we go along. So VoiceAmerica.tv became a reality June of 2010. Yeah. Since that day, we were still building and growing our radio channels, but we really stepped into the TV space probably about a year, possibly a year and a half ago.
Yeah.
Even though it's been existent, and we have done great projects with it, we've done Super Bowl appearances.
Yeah, just because we're doing radio doesn't mean that we're not doing the video aspect. I mean, we have video over here on our Facebook Live. We have video in the studio with the camera rolling so we can put the content up on VATV. So we know there's value in both, which is the reason why we do both, or we would not be wasting our time.
And as a father, I can't choose one or the other, you know. But anyway, so we've got some good stuff coming up. We have two very, very solid guests on the show. One is Voice America's very own TV program director, Mr. Jon Missal.
Yeah,
John's Missal. Got some extensive background. And also we're going to be talking to Miss Rebecca Hall Gruyter. Rebecca goes a couple years back with us. In fact, you guys have met Robert Cellino a couple of weeks ago. She works with Robert on the radio side, and she works with John on the TV side. So you'll hear a lot of good quality information from Rebecca, and she'll have some good feedback. Okay. So talking about online audiences. First of all, there's 7.2 billion people across the globe.
Yeah, a lot of people.
Now, you have to minus the third world countries, and people can't really afford this, so that takes that number down considerably.
Yeah.
So when when you read the book and you start going through chapter 3, choosing your medium, radio, TV, or both, you're going to find out a lot of statistical information. You know, there's 123 million people ages 12 and up that consume content at least three times a week. The hourly time spent on consuming internet media is about, it was 12 hours 2 years ago. Up to this point, you're looking at least 15 hours plus a week.
Yeah, there is a considerable climb. I know that you and I and the management team earlier this week were doing an exercise in the conference room on like the power of social media and some of those things, and to look at the staggering numbers of, you know, I'm not going to get too technical, but all the conversions and all of the traffic that happens as a result of some of those marketing efforts, I was completely blown away at the amount of time grown adults are on Facebook.
You know what? Time changes, man. It's been years, again, being in the industry for 22 years, especially over the last 10 years, I've watched and had to change, have the company adapt. And VoiceAmerica has always stayed ahead of everybody when it comes to the digital space. So I'm happy that we've been able to stay, you know, ahead of the curve, and we're going to continue to do that. Absolutely.
Speaking of staying ahead of the curve, just a couple of calendar things for you guys to remember. Jeff and I are jet-setting out to Florida tomorrow, getting set up for the Pitbull Conference on October 24th. We'll be going live on voiceamerica.com/live events, bringing you all of the big hitters in the hard money realm. And then right after that...
Oh, but also, ahead. I just want to remind that we did the Small Business Expo yesterday. We did it live, so you can actually go to our live event.
There's a mistake right there. I have it on my notes.
You skip around and say, I'm not even on that page. Okay, so you go to the live events page now. You can hear what we did at the Small Business Expo.
Yeah, Small Business Expo was great. Had a good time with you there yesterday. I think we were vibing well with all the partners out there, and looking forward to some of those other ones coming up in 2017. And not anything lesser than the best for our Voice America listeners, AdTech New York, November 2nd and 3rd. We'll be out there bringing that to you live as well in conjunction with AdTech.
That's going to be a good one. We're going to meet a lot of our hosts out there as well.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back, and we'll bring you some awesome guests from our radio show right here, Fighting Your Frequency. I'm Ryan Treasure.
And I'm Jeff Spenard.
We'll be right back right after these messages.
And welcome back to Finding Your Frequency. I'm your host, Jeff Spenard.
I'm Ryan Treasure.
And we are back. Today's topic is choosing your medium, radio, TV, or both. We have a professional in the studio right now. This man has been, well, first of all, this man has over 40 years experience in the business, music and entertainment fields. Mr. Jon Missal brings a passion and vision into the VoiceAmerica family that is seldom seen in today's competitive markets. Whether pursuing guests or sponsors for his hosts, he has been called charming, but with a relentless pursuit for perfection towards accomplishing his goals. Welcome, Mr. Jon Missal.
Thank you both for having me. It's I'm very humbled and honored to be here with you both.
Excellent.
Yeah,
excellent.
Jon, we really appreciate you taking time. I know you have a lot of TV clients and things that you're working with, and always making maneuvers and, you know, taking care of the fantastic hosts that we have. So thanks for taking time out to be on with us today.
I wouldn't miss it.
Yeah. I got to say, you know, we go back now. I mean, we go back maybe 8-9 years. Jon is a rock with the company. He is part of the family. He is Voice America with us. So, and he's done a lot. Reason why I have Jon on the show today is because he's got so much experience both in radio, because that's where he started with us, and when we launched the TV network, Jon was the man who took over and, you know, led the pack for TV. So, Jon, listen, tell us a little bit about your background and, you know, how you got to Voice America.
Well, I got out of media. I was out of media for a couple of years, but it goes back a long way. That 1971. We're making a long story short.
I was one.
Sorry, but that's okay. I love that.
Throw it out there.
Making a very long story short.
He does have 40 years of experience.
Right. For the first time ever, I had a privilege of having Walter Cronkite and be at a private party with him, and him listening to an audio tape I did and say that I should be in the business. And it's always been an underlying passion, even with being in the music industry for a while. It's still part of the media, and you deal with it constantly. And you can deal with all the back end of it and the back scenes. And that's what makes it enjoyable to me, is watching and helping people go and grow and succeed on a platform, and especially a platform, without sounding self-serving, like we have, that goes out around the world where people can be successful. I mean, I'd much rather talk about them than myself.
Sure.
I was lucky enough to have brilliant people, including both of you, you know, guide me through different aspects that I didn't know about or add to my knowledge.
Right. You always gotta keep learning, continue to learn, especially, you know, in the technology space, which is what the space that we're in. And when Walter Cronkite gives you a blessing or tells you you should be doing radio or media, you follow it. So
yeah, you better listen.
Glad you're here, buddy. Okay, John, you are the Voice America TV program director. You oversee everything that happens on the TV side. Talk to us about clients you've worked with and what's been the medium that they've been, or how did you get them going along with the medium?
The biggest part of having a client that wants to be successful is that they have a long-term vision. And they can see that vision and they know that it takes time to build it. You know, I love radio dearly. I also love TV. I think it's essential that people have full media broadcasting platforms, not blog stations or web stations. It's nice to have the...
Tell us the difference.
Well, the difference is having really... In a full network broadcasting company, you have the support of so many different departments. You have, you know, and really it's one of the reasons I work here. I love the fact that we have the graphics people, we have the voiceover people, we have the live engineers, and we have that kind of support on the TV, the social media, everything that goes in behind the scenes where most people think you just walk in, get behind a camera, or you walk in and get behind a mic, depending on your medium. And that's what's gratifying, is to see people with visions that can understand that and they're willing to listen and learn they go forward.
Now, you're very thorough with the prospects and the clients that you work with. Talk to us about maybe one of the people you're working with and one of the projects you're on right now.
Well, the perfect example, and I believe she'll be a guest later on in the show, would be
Rebecca Hall Gruyter.
Yes, exactly. Not only is she a terrifically positive person, but here's a person that had a vision, built a radio show, built a TV network on Voice America, built a channel, I should say, on a Voice America TV network. She comes along. She has 7-8 other shows on her. And now she's progressing to, not only will she keep all of her clients and her shows on the Voice America and her channel on Voice America, but they will also syndicate to other Voice America channels, but we will also be building her own private label network further. So she's just continually taking the steps, along with keeping her radio show, to continue to go and grow as she goes forward.
And that's something I think everybody should understand. Voice America goes beyond just being a distribution, we're a distribution company when it comes to content, but we have full support, be it production, be it creative, technology, marketing, branding. It's an organization that will help you with every aspect you need, but we're also here to build you a platform that you're able to run yourself. We're just powering it. You know, VoiceAmerica is just the name on the bottom of the screen that says powered by. It's your network now. So you're capable of building whatever you want to build for your brand.
And that's the best part of it, is when somebody comes with their ideas, to be able to share your knowledge with them, let them see the behind the scenes or the better ways sometimes to direct their shows and or their own particular clients, along with sharing the ideas together to get an even better product by, you know, two heads being better than one.
Very true. Very true. So if I have to ask you, and I don't even know if I have to ask you this question, but choosing your medium, radio, TV, or both?
By far both. even though I work 95% of my life now in TV, I honestly would say it's 51-49. There's all, you know, talk radio is going to be around forever and a day. Yeah. It's just going to be around a whole lot more on an internet platform.
Sure.
Yeah. However, the new wave moving forward is definitely video also, and being able to leverage that.
It's a huge populace, absolutely.
To me, I feel that's why it's so important to people that really want to be in the industry, that whether it takes them 6 months or it takes them a year or it takes them 2 years, they need to look at, to separate themselves from other people doing what they're doing.
Sure, sure.
That they have that full platform, because it does separate them. It does give them real credibility, not sure. perceived credibility in the industry of what they're doing.
Agreed, agreed. Now, let me ask you, when you're talking to somebody, are you establishing whether or not they're a better fit for radio or TV, or are you just talking to a specific person right now for a specific medium?
When I'm talking to people, I really want to listen more than I'm talking. I'm really trying to decipher what I personally think is best for them. However, they need to follow their passion and their business. If I recommend something to them and they don't have the same kind of passion for it as another avenue that they want to do, it's only going to be half the effort. So I want to listen to them. I want to develop them in the many ways that they want to go down a road to be successful. I don't want them to live my vision. I want to help them live theirs.
Well put.
Yeah, well, that's said. Very well put. I really like that about you, John, that you're so open-minded with the people that you work with, and you're able to kind of take that passion, like you said, and direct them down a road. Because you're right, if you're not passionate about something, you're only going to do the bare minimum to get the job done rather than going in all feet first and ready to really rock and roll on the avenue that you're trying to run down. So that is a really great point. One thing to add, right, when we're talking about choosing the medium, I know you said 51-49% was your kind of split on that. Tell people why it's important to do both.
Well, it gives you a global reach. It's almost like you don't go on it. I mean, you're always going to have a global reach on each of those platforms. But it's like going in social media as an analogy. As you all know, I'm very big on those and cliches.
Yes, you are.
But when you... If you just did Facebook for your entire life and you left out Twitter or LinkedIn, depending upon your successes and what you're trying to accomplish in business, you're leaving a massive right. part of your audience out.
Yep.
Whereas when you have both, you have the ability to reach everyone that you want to reach in every particular genre, if you do it correctly.
Sure.
You're going to find clients. I love media, but I also love sports. Okay.
Sure, sure.
And there's other people that watch sports that watch business shows.
Sure.
Just because they have a favorite thing does not mean that they can't be helped another way, which again is another way why radio and TV helps you reach those people, especially on a global basis as we go.
Sure. Now, another question that I have, and I'm just spitballing this out there. Yeah, I like numbers. I like to know what's going on, especially with my own company. But when you look at TV and radio, what is the time spent on video versus audio?
Well, you're always going to spend a little bit more time in video, and maybe not you personally as a host of a show.
Sure.
Depending on how far you want to technically dive into it yourself. It takes you a little bit more time to put your videos together because you have editors. You want that quality professional look. I mean, it's things we can also do for you, but a lot of our clients, some of them we do some work for us, we do some work for them. Some of them have their own video people, and they're on their own time schedules.
Sure.
And then they need to review it, et cetera, et cetera. When it comes to radio and doing a show, I personally believe that besides your hour show, if you're putting in, unless you're going to make this a full-time career, if you're putting more than 2 hours in a week on a radio show, that you're overthinking it, you're probably overscripting it, and you're probably going to fail.
I don't know if I necessarily agree with the last part about, you know, if you put more than, you're going to fail. I think, you know, there's a lot of hosts that have multiple things that they want to include in their show. So, and again, that all goes with preparation. Okay. So, you know, I agree with what you're saying, and I appreciate that. You obviously work on both sides of the coin here. So, but yeah. So
no, I just got to put that in there. Maybe, perhaps I didn't phrase that very well because you're right. Because some people, as long as they're not doing their interviews ahead of time, and that's where people, I think, tend to do it. They spend more time, and then when they get on a show, they're stale.
Okay, good. So I'm glad that was cleared up because I want to make sure that the information we're giving to people, especially when they're trying to think, okay, I want to do a show. How do I do this? And get good feedback. Then, you know, they were able to get proper information from the show. Ryan.
John, I want to thank you so much for being on in this segment. And I have one thing I have to throw in here. I got some statistics for real quick while we go to commercial break. 67.4% of all internet users consume internet radio in a given month. That's 176 million human beings in the United States on a monthly basis. Now you want to talk video? Video. YouTube alone reaches 95% of the entire internet population. Jesus. So that goes to tell you where there's a little bit higher consumption on the video side, which goes to your point about spending more time on the video. But however, 174 million and 67.4% of the internet population is nothing to shake a stick at on the radio side.
Exactly. But you know what? You got to look at the stats beyond that. You got to look at the age groups and demographics. If you've got 12-year-olds looking at dogs doing backflips, okay, that's great. If you're trying to build something that's going to be sustainable and that's actually going to have quality content that's going to educate the populace, which is what we do here at Voice America, then it's going to be a different audience and different stats.
Absolutely it is.
John, thanks for being on the show. Glad to have you. And we'll see you, I'm sure, in the future.
Hey, thanks so much for having me, guys. It was a lot of fun. Love the show.
We'll be right back right after these messages. Stay tuned. Rebecca Hall Gruyter up next.
Welcome back to Finding Your Frequency. I'm your host, Jeff Spenard.
And I'm Ryan Treasure. Welcome back to the show.
And we've had a great first two segments of the show. In segment number one, we talked a little bit about, you know, age groups and demographics, you know, who's consuming the content, digital media becoming more of the consumed content. So, you know, moving into this show and this segment, can we start again, please?
Absolutely. And you gotta get your mic there, so.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Traditional. See, I didn't finish off my own little. Okay.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. In 4, 3, 2.
Welcome back to Finding Your Frequency. I'm your host, Jeff Spenard.
And I'm co-host Ryan Treasure. Welcome back to the show.
It's been a great show so far. We opened up the show. We talked about age groups and demographics for the radio and TV segments. Matt, we're going to do this just one more time.
Okay, Matt, 25
Should
minutes.
Should I just lose this part? We'll just get into...
Yeah, we got to be...
I'm trying to go back to the beginning. Then I was going to say, and John has some great information, but we haven't talked to John yet. So I'm just going to come in with...
When this airs, we would have talked to John.
Oh, no.